Hi guys, we made here this platform. That's to work on altitude. I go around first. It consists of two parts. This is one part and that's the other part. And we can move them in height. Here are the sensors, so we know where we have to stop at the top, and we know where we have to stop at the bottom. And here manually we can bring them closer to each other. So the idea is that in the middle there will be the object where they are working on, and then they can lower and higher the platform to work more easily at the object they are working on. So let's go upstairs. They made a stair here to go upstairs. And here will be the object, and then here we can, with this control, we can move the platform. We can move it down, we can move it up, emergency stop, lamp test, active when the platform is active, and alarm. Here also, when the platform is active, we will have the orange light and a buzzer. So if we move now down, takes five seconds before it starts moving, and now it's moving. So now the platform is going down. You have to keep the button pressed, and to go up, you press the button up again, 5 seconds time out, so that the people are warned that it's going up, and then moving up until you release the button or until the proximity sensors are hit. I'll show you the inside of the cabinet, the front panel. Here the inside, main switch, fuse, then power supply, 24 volts, Siemens logo, automatization module, some safety relay for the emergency stop, some interface relays, and these are contactors, turnaround contactors and motor protectors. That's all there is in there. In principle, it's not so difficult to make this circuit, but you have four sensors for one part of the platform plus two buttons, so that makes a lot of combinations. I made it with a Carnot diagram of 6 inputs, so it's not that easy, but it's not impossible to make it. So the build-up is quite easy, it's nothing special inside there. Okay guys, thank you for watching.